KCAA Loma Linda, 1050 AM, 106.5 FM, and now 102.3 FM.
Welcome to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from the Amp.TV mobile studios here in fabulous Las Vegas. That's AAMP.TV. Today's show is brought to you by Legal Shield, providing legal protection and peace of mind. Legal Shield can help with traffic tickets, texting and driving, DUIs, court appearances, drunken public, estate planning, and a whole lot more. For more information, contact Legal Shield at 213-245-1305. That's 213-245-1305. Or visit them online at nocourt.us for more information. That's nocourt.us. And a big welcome to everybody listening in on Magic 97.9 FM right here in Las Vegas, as well as our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast, Talk 1490 WIRB in Southern Alabama, and the Florida Panhandle, as well as all of our friends watching on hotel television in 650,000 rooms from coast to coast, and those streaming at thesportscircus.com plus AMTV right off the very top. Have a special co-pilot today. In fact, we're going to let him introduce himself.
How you doing? I'm Neil Donell from the band Chicago. How's everybody doing out there? Hope you're all healthy.
Neil Donell from the band Chicago. Holy smokes, that would be the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame Chicago, correct?
That's the one and only, yeah.
That's the one and only. Welcome in from Toronto.
Yeah, up in the Great White North. We're having a great heat wave right now, actually.
That's okay. That's right, because guess what? Things are going to heat up here. I understand you got a guitar, and you never know. You may break out into song a little bit. Play a little something for us.
Up to checking the tuning, see if it's in tune.
Right. All right. So Neil, you know, this is the Sports Circus. We do talk sports, but we talk music and sports. And you know what? I know since you're in Toronto, I know you're a hockey fan. You've got to be a hockey fan, but not necessarily of the Leafs, maybe of the Canadiens.
I do have to tread lightly here because I do live in Toronto, but I'm actually a former Montrealer. I lived in Montreal for most of my formative years. So kind of a dyed-in-the-wool Montreal Canadiens fan, yeah, pretty much to the end.
So there are the Habs and then the have-nots, if I'm not mistaken, right?
Yeah.
Tell everybody do you know how Habs actually came to sort of like that name that a lot of people refer them to?
Well, that's a derivative, you know, it's les habitants, you know, that's inhabitants, essentially, is the derivative. Habs is from the word habitant, which is inhabitants, people who live, you know, there in Montreal.
Absolutely. That one's for all those people in Toronto that may not get it. You know, we had a we had a signal that reached Toronto for quite some time. And I tell you, the hockey fans over there, I get it. But then again, all of our signal actually stemmed from Buffalo. And of course, all the people in Buffalo, they didn't give a you-know-what about what's going on over in Toronto, only because, let's face it, you know, they're on the other side of the lake. It didn't really matter.
That's it. I mean, you know, there's a great rivalry and always has been between Toronto and Montreal, but it's almost like a triangle now with Buffalo in there because, you know, when Buffalo and Toronto go at it, you know, there's some rivalry there as well, yeah.
That's good stuff. All right, so let me ask you this. What about rivalry between bands? I mean, does that actually exist?
You know, on this level, no. I mean, you know, I've been in the music business for a long time now, professionally for, more than 35 years. And, you know, when you're sort of in the club level, I find that there's more of a a competition almost going on for the work. But at a certain level, that seems to fall away, and everybody's kind of, you know, incredibly supportive of each other. I mean, Chicago has toured with so many different bands over the years. I mean, 3 years ago, it was Earth, Wind & Fire. And then 2 years ago, or no, 4 years ago, it was Earth, Wind & Fire. And then it was the Doobie Brothers. And 2 years ago, it was REO Speedwagon. And this summer, we were supposed to be touring with Rick Springfield. And of course, that's been put on hold and moved to next year. But no, it's always really very supportive, I found.
So in the grand scheme of things, if you were to select who you were going to be touring with, if you in a perfect world, Neil, who would you love to tour with?
You mean with Chicago as a band?
Yeah. Yes. Yes.
Well, you know, the consensus seems to be, and I guess, I mean, I like all the bands, you know, that I mean, it's been the Beach Boys and America and, you know, just a really long list. But I think stylistically, because there's horns in both groups, I mean, I guess one of the best marriages has always been Earth, Wind & Fire in Chicago.
Right.
You know, it just seems to be, the energy is there. The camaraderie is just exceptional. And, you know, there's just a great mutual respect and love for everybody. I mean, it goes on with all the bands, but Earth, Wind & Fire in Chicago is, I think 4 or 5 times now that combination
really?
Has occurred. Yeah. Yeah, it goes way back.
I would have never guessed that.
Yeah, it's very
special. But I do like the fact that when you have the horns and they have the horns, I get it. It makes sense.
Yeah, this is it. And when, you know, when the bands get together at the end of the show on stage, there's like 20 people on stage. It's a big party. It's amazing.
But when your band goes on, I mean, look, it's kind of like the soundtrack of America, the soundtrack of people's lives. I mean, how many people have gotten married to Chicago's music? How many people have grown their families to Chicago's music, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Well, that's, you know, when we do the meet and greets after the show and before the show, very rarely does somebody not come up to the band and say, you know, that Color My World was their wedding song, or You're the Inspiration was their wedding song, or Feeling Stronger got them through a really tough time in their life. I've heard that many times as well. It's, yeah, this music is very critical to a lot of people's lives. You know, it's marked little moments in the lives of so many people. Very, very special.
Right. Welcome back to everybody listening in on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast, watching also on hotel television, here with Neil Donell, who handles the lead vocals for Rock and Roll Hall of Fame band Chicago. And so, Neil, when you were a lot younger and in your, let's say, go back to your teen years, there was probably some music that inspired you. And what was it that you looked at and said, I want to do that? How did you know that this is what you wanted to do?
It's you know, that's a great question, but because it's my, I think my story is a bit curious, because there was no music in my family anywhere. You know, most of the people that I've worked with my whole life have come from a musical background of some sort, but in my case, there was absolutely none. My father was a police officer, and my mom was a stay-at-home mom. And I don't know, when I was in grade school, I felt compelled to join the school choir, which you had to audition for, because they had to know if you could hear pitch and things, of course. And then when I was in high school, I got in my first band. I guess I was 14. And it was so foreign to my family. They just had, you know, they didn't know what to say or what to do. In fact, my mother has heard me perform live once, and my father never did. He died about 10 years ago. So,
wow.
Yeah. So, you know, just music just resonated with me so much. In the beginning, it was, you know, Black Sabbath and Led Zeppelin, stuff like that. And then the first Chicago record came out. I remember it vividly. I remember hearing Does Anybody Know What Time It Is? You know, written by and sung by my good friend Robert Lamb, you know, who's still one of the founding members of the band and still, you know, sounding great, and a dear friend. And that kind of changed my life, that record. And I became a huge fan of the band, you know. And it's so curious that many, many years later, I end up being in the band. You know, it's quite bizarre.
That's got to be a surreal moment. I mean, you listen to it, you're like, wow, this is great for years and years and years. And guess what? Suddenly, you're singing for the band. What are the odds of that? How many people get to experience those ridiculous odds?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know, and I'm the only Canadian, to my knowledge, that's ever been a member of the band. So that was unusual in itself. And I mean, I have a bunch of friends of mine who acquaintances that play with different artists. I've got, you know, a friend of mine that plays with Brian Adams, and another guy that I is more of an acquaintance, a gentleman named Larry Gowan. He's been with the band Styx for about 20 years. So it was just a curious way that it all came to pass. You know, I was sitting in a restaurant in New York about 4 or 5 years ago, and I got a message from somebody in management, and it kind of went from there.
Wow, that's incredible. Hey, listen, Neil, we're coming up on break here in about 30 seconds. This is great. So what a treat to have Neil Donell with us from Chicago. And wow, going from just listening to him casually, whatever, kind of growing up with him, being inspired by them, and now being the guy. That's got to be a remarkable experience. We're going to dig into that a little bit more. Maybe we're going to get that guitar out over on your side. You're going to play a little something for us, too. What do you think about that?
We'll see.
All right, folks, we're going to be back with Neil Donell from Chicago here on the Sports Circus. Lots more to come. Don't go anywhere. Do you have any questions about legal issues? Have you ever been stopped by a police officer and issued a ticket that you're scared to deal with? Have you ever been in trouble with the law and don't know what to do? Do you have a will or power of attorney question? Is your home being foreclosed upon and you don't know where to turn? Maybe you were given a contract that you don't understand. For freedom and a worry-free solution, call for Legal Shield today at 213-245-1305. It's that simple. You will have access to high-quality law firms that will fight for you for less than a dollar a day. Peace of mind is just a call away. That's for Legal Shield. Call 213-245-1305 or visit us at nocourt.us. It's justice for all and not justice for some. Are you a small business owner or pursuing the dream of starting your own company? Do you know where to start or how to grow that existing business? The American Business Trust Company has the answers you need. The American Business Trust Company can help you with startup capital, business strategy, sales and marketing, and establishing your company with a physical location or on the internet. You decide. You bring the idea, the American Business Trust Company can help with the rest. For a free evaluation, you may visit them online at abtrustco.com. That's abtrustco.com or call them at 657-600-1876. That's the American Business Trust Company, 657-600-1876. Call them today. They can help your business right away. This is Sal Tuzzolino, host and remaster of The Sports Circus. Why listen to the same old dog and pony show that you've heard all day long? The Sports Circus covers everything that other shows don't or are too scared to cover. There's no primetime show like it out here that'll punch you in the mouth and you'll beg for more. You can call in and participate with our chaos if you dare. Join me and celebrity guests for Havoc and Mayhem weekdays at 5 p.m. Pacific here on Amp TV or stream the show live at thesportscircus.com. Remember, folks, it's a circus and we prove it every day.
Do you know someone with a drug or alcohol problem? Get help right now. Insurance may cover everything. Stop the drug and alcohol nightmare. Are drug and alcohol problems hitting you too close to home? Get help right now. Insurance may cover everything.
800-831-1560. 800-831-1560. 800-831-1560. That's 800-831-1560.
All right, break it up.
Excite me.
Shut up and start talking. Quiet, numbskulls. I'm broadcasting.
Hey,
Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from the Amp.TV mobile studios in fabulous Las Vegas. That's AAMP. This segment brought to you in part by Kelly Vegas, helping people create and host their very own radio, TV, or multimedia talk show. Kelly Vegas can help them with everything they need to get out of sitting in hours of traffic every day, commuting back and forth to work, or sitting around their house trying to figure out what's my next step. Maybe I want to be a radio star, a TV star, whatever. Maybe you want your own podcast. For more information, contact Kelly Vegas at 949-445-1119. That's 949-445-1119. Or visit them online at kellyvegas.com for more information. That's C-A-L-I Vegas.
Do you owe the IRS $10,000 or more in back taxes? Are you being audited or investigated? Has the IRS sent you a letter demanding payment? You may not owe what they claim. Make this free call to the Tax Doctor now. Let them negotiate with the IRS on your behalf.
800-492-4190. 800-492-4190. That's 800-492-4190.com.
All right, folks, back here with Neil Donnell, singer for Chicago Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. I'll tell you what, this guy, by the way, just in case you're kind of keeping score, Neil has incredible range in his voice. If I'm not mistaken, 4 octaves. 4, is that not correct?
Yeah, that's about right. Yeah. Kept me busy for quite a few years.
So explain what that means. So the people that don't really understand the musical side of things, kind of like myself, largely, but explain it to the people what it is that you're capable of with your voice.
Well, it just means your voice can go really low to really high, essentially.
And that's, you know, that's without being kicked.
Yeah, without being kicked, without any prodding whatsoever. And it just, you know, what it does essentially, because I made my living for a very long time, and still do to some extent as a session singer, as a studio singer, and doing voice work. So, you know, one day you might get called to do a country voice, which is, most part, it's usually a little deeper a voice, or, you know, one day somebody might call me to do Frank Sinatra, or the next day I have to be Michael Bolton, or I'm Vera Bocelli, or so it gives you the vocal range to do a lot of different styles. You know, that's what kept me working in the business for a very long time.
So you've done 10,000 sessions. 10,000.
Yeah, more than 10,000 recording sessions. Yeah, it boggles my mind to think of it. But.
Wow. Yeah. That is absolutely amazing. That deserves an astounding round of applause.
It was, you know, back in the heyday, most of it was commercial jingles, although I've worked on a ton of albums for different people over the years, too, and in television and radio. I mean, you've probably heard my voice hundreds of times and didn't know it was me. I remember walking into downtown Disney in Orlando with my kids, you know, 10 years ago or something, when they were little, and hearing my voice, you know, the speakers in a store there. And it would always take me 10 or 15 seconds to realize that sounds familiar. Hey, wait a second, that's me. And it still happens. I forget about, you know, what I've done over the years. And people still send me songs, you know, that I do a lot of song demos for people, you know, songwriters that have publishing deals who write songs, and their publishers shop the songs around for them, you know, to artists who don't write but are looking for songs. So they hire professional singers to sing these songs. And, you know, I've done a lot. In fact, I'm doing one tomorrow for somebody here. And that's part of it too. So, you know, the more versatile you are and the more range you have, the more likely you are to work.
Wow. Yeah, I'm trying to wrap my head around the idea of 10,000 of these, and I couldn't pick your voice out because you're kind of like a voice impressionist too, are you not?
Yeah. Yes, absolutely. That's part of it. I mean, the people out there that have kids, you know, there's the name escapes me. I'm the voice of a PBS show that teaches kids to learn how to read. I do a lot of the voice work on that show. I'm the voice of a show called Mighty Machines, which was geared, I guess, mostly towards little boys, but it's all about these big machines, and that's been around for a long while. And when people find out I'm the voice of that, it's also, you know, they're quite stunned by that. And yeah, I've worked with so many different people over the years, you know, behind the scenes mostly.
So when people will come up to you and they'll say, hey, could give us your best Frank Sinatra or something like that. Do people actually do that to you because they know that you have such incredible range?
No, because for me, it's not something that I generally can pick out of the air. You know, I don't work like that. I'll give you an example. I mean, a bunch of years ago, somebody called me to do Frank Sinatra for, I think it was Ice Capades or something. It was a TV special, and they had five or six Frank Sinatra songs to do in the show. And I mean, Sinatra wasn't the voice that I had done before. So I always call and I say I had a little eureka moment where somebody will call me and they would say, you know, can you do this voice or that voice? And even if I've not done it before, I always do the Richard Branson thing and say yes and figure it out later. So somebody called me to do Frank Sinatra, and I said, okay. And I had, I think, 3 or 4 days, and I had to sit down with these Sinatra tunes and find the sound and find the phrasing and all the things that made Sinatra Sinatra. And when the thing went to air, people thought that the songs were actually needle drops. They thought they were the actual recordings of the songs. I had gotten so close to
it.
Yeah.
Wow.
And I've done that.
Folks, we're here with Neil Donell, vocalist for Chicago, lead vocalist for rock and roll band, Rock and Roll Hall of Fame band Chicago. Unbelievable. This guy has basically done it all. And a big welcome to everybody listening in on Magic 97.9 FM right here in Las Vegas and our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast, iHeartRadio, and hotel television as well from coast to coast. So, Neil, with these needle drops, tell everybody what that term means.
Well, a needle drop is when they use in advertising or mostly, they use the actual recording. You know, they get the rights to the actual recording, you know, from the artist and the publisher to use it. But a lot of the times, you know, they don't get that. Long time ago, Bette Midler had a lawsuit that she won, and that kind of changed the face of advertising in terms of the music, because somebody had done an impression of her, and the lawsuit was based on it. It kind of had took away her means to make a living. Somebody was impersonating her, essentially. So you can get the rights to a song now for advertising purposes, if that's what they want to do. But it doesn't necessarily give you the rights to the performance of the song. That's a separate entity.
Interesting. Okay, yeah. So out of all the sessions you've done, how many people that you've ever seen or heard was able to duplicate your voice?
That's another good question. A bunch of years ago, somebody told me that there was somebody that who was attempting to impersonate me or, you know, imitate me. And there was a guy around that some people sometimes thought it was me, but it wasn't. So the whole thing is like, you know, what's my real voice? You know, that was the whole thing, you know, what. So you're used to doing the voices of other people. So who are you really? So I eventually started putting out my own music so people could, you know, hear my own stuff. And I put a record out, I guess it's about a couple of years ago now, but people can find it on my website if they want to go there. It's a great, mostly covers, a couple of original songs on it. There's actually one Chicago song on the record as well. So yeah, I'm still writing and recording my own things. In fact, I'm getting ready to release something new Canadian, and you know, had that accent. But yeah, I mean, I've done a lot of different accents, and I've worked on. I used to do dubbing in films quite a bit, where I would literally be a dozen different actors in the in the movie, we had a few lines here and there, and I would have to change accents and voices for every one of them.
Okay. I like that, because when you think of those people that are really good at impressions, whether it's singing, whether it's just standing up on stage and doing it, my favorite impressionist was Rich Little. And, you know, Rich is still doing it in Las Vegas. He did the best impressions I've ever seen in the world. But I can't imagine doing a song version of it and actually being able to really play guitar at the same time. Now, folks, it's a lot harder to play guitar and sing than it is just to play guitar. I mean, I can't do either. And I just can't imagine trying to coordinate my fingers and then trying to coordinate a voice and then doing an impression of somebody else and maybe in a foreign voice on top of that. That's got to be really difficult, isn't it?
Yeah, it combines a whole bunch of different skill sets, you know, but it's strange. It seems like almost, you know, it's a Canadian thing because, you know, Rich Little is Canadian. He's originally from Ottawa, you know, which is, you know, 4 hours away from where I am. And another gentleman, he's French Canadian. His name is André Philippe Gagnon. And he came to notoriety on the Tonight Show some years ago because he did We Are the World. That came out and did all the voices from that. And he's still out there performing. I think he's in Vegas every now and again, you know, and he's a really talented guy, and interesting and fun to watch.
You know, in the last segment, Neil, I had mentioned something about doing maybe a multi-collaboration or whatnot. So here in Las Vegas, what had happened just recently, you know, there's been some things that have gone on, of course, in the world health-wise and whatnot. Well, what they did here in Las Vegas, and there's a fine gentleman by the name of Alan Glist, Glist Entertainment. Alan's it's the guy that runs the Bronx Wanderers, the Menopause Show, the Thomas John Show at Caesar's Palace, et cetera. Alan's is a good friend and just a great human. And so, you know, to try to raise money for the stagehands and the singers and the dancers and so forth, people that weren't really working and making a lot of money during a time when everything was down, they put together a project with 20 singers. Imagine this, everybody doing this virtually, 20 singers singing a new song, kind of like We Are the World, right? And then imagine 20 people singing it a cappella. And then, I'm sorry, strike that, 50 people singing it a cappella. And then 20 wow. separate musicians in their locations, all playing their part of it, whether you're playing drums, whether you're playing a keyboard or whatnot, right? And so imagine doing, mixing down all the voices, mixing down all the musical piece, putting it all together and coming out with this magical piece of music that everybody did this from afar. I've never seen anything like that before. And imagine the work it takes to put something like that together. I think they did it in record time of 3 weeks thereabouts. It was crazy. A whole new song was written. So the reason I had asked you about writing a song and getting it down and laying the vocals on the track, etc., imagine how long it would take for the average group of 70 people to do such a thing. Isn't that crazy?
It is. And there's a lot of it going on now. And it's because the technology, you know, has come so far. You know, it's so good now. And there are so many people who are very adept at it, you know, just great engineers and great technicians, you know, as you know. And so they can pull these things together. And a friend of mine made a really, really great point to me not so long ago. You know, he said, regardless of the situation, you know, the circumstances, creative people are going to continue to create. It's just, they have to. And so right. There's a lot going on, and people are trying to keep people happy and positive. And I mean, it's beautiful. I've seen so many of them.
Hey, everybody, this is Barry Katz from the Industry Standard Podcast, and you're listening to the Sports Circus with Sal Tuzzolino.
Hey,
Yeah.
Just the idea that people have the opportunity to do this at their very own, in their very own homes, whatever. And I think it gives new perspective to people that thought that they could never do something special from home. Well, all they had to do is dig a little bit deeper. Think about, as you're writing songs, how many songs have you written?
Oh, no, I haven't written many. I've maybe written 50 or 60 songs in my life. I'm not, like I said, I've never been terribly, terribly prolific. You know, I might write 3 or 4 or 5 things a year. That's about it. I need to say something significant or important. I can't sort of just write, you know, for the exercise of writing. It has to be meaningful for me in order to finish and write the song.
Got it. So you have to have a real sense of purpose. By the way, folks, we're here with Neil Donnell, lead vocals for Rock and Roll Hall of Fame band Chicago. Big welcome back to everybody watching us on hotel television from coast to coast and listening in on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast and watching on AMP TV. So, Neil, you've written 50 or 60. Well, you know, I haven't really written that many songs. That's crazy. It's a huge amount. The average person can't even understand what it's like to write one song. But, oh, you've done casually 50 or 60. That's crazy.
Well, yeah, I mean, you know, like I said, I've been doing this for a very long time. So, you know, and as I said, I need to say something significant in order for me to be motivated to finish the song. So the songs that I have written, you know, all are say something about my life or something about my philosophy of life. So. But, you know, there's, you know, guys in the band like Robert Lamb and Jimmy Panko and Lee Lockney, you know, these guys are prolific writers, especially Robert. Robert is writing all the time. And, you know, just he's written so many great songs and, you know, has his own style, which is very singularly, you know, him. Yeah.
Okay, so listen, we've got about a minute and a half or so left in the segment. You want to take us out to break with maybe something that you've written? Maybe one of your own?
Gosh, I just...
Can you do it?
Let me just think what I could pull out. Sure.
All right, you got about a minute. Oh, here we go. Everybody at home is making an adjustment on the guitar. Here we go. It's Neil Donnell. Looks like we've got about 60 seconds.
I took it hard, harder than I should. When it come believing, I never was much good. Oh, but I can hold on till there's nothing left to hold on to. What happened to me will not happen to you. No, no, no.
The following is a sample from the Sports Circus.
Here, he certainly knows something about making things difficult on the competition.
He's a punisher.
Yeah, just break the ribs.
Yeah,
just, you know, I still haven't broke someone's collarbone yet in a boxing match, and that's my goal. I want to put somebody in the shoulder.
There's time, Bronco.
I want to put somebody in the shoulder.
You got your bucket list snap. Over here of pain.
Yeah, bucket list of pain.
I haven't broken somebody's collarbone. I've broken everything else.
Which reminds me, I was thinking the reason he probably doesn't wear anything when it's cold outside is he figures he'll just grab some nerd and squeeze him real hard and squeeze the warmth out of him.
Squeeze the warmth out of him. That's a great statement. I have not broke someone's collarbone in the ring yet.
I've never heard that before.
I have not. I can't wait.
Is there a reason you said in the ring?
I can't wait.
Is it that you've broken collarbones just outside of the ring?
You did catch that, right?
He said in the ring.
Yeah, exactly. He got him on the curtain. He got him on the edge of the ring and broke his collarbone.
I had to get Sal's name name right.
Well, that's Sal the floor sweeper. That's his new name.
Sal the bookkeeper.
Hey, yeah, but even my last name.
Add that one to the bank, you know?
But no, Alicia, you even got my last name wrong. That's why I said my name.
I know it starts with
bleeding.
A V. It starts with a V.
He said a V. Really? Quick, where's the punch sound? 400 punches.
Here's the punch sound.
Right, exactly. He was real. Look, he almost knocked out the microphone.
Alicia, that's why they have cue cards, right? Don't let the name bother you. Just bring a cue card with you next time.
Yeah, but people can't read my name off a cue card.
Or change your name to Joe Smith or something. Jeez, make it easy.
Yeah.
Because the concept on that was that during I throw a flag downfield for DPI, so
How
to speak.
How far could you throw a flag? What's your record for throwing a flag?
Well, you know what people don't realize?
I know there's beanbags or something.
There's beanbags, marks the spots. Flags, you've got a little sand in it, too, and you roll it up to a little ball to try to get to the
record?
Spot. You know, people think that you're throwing it a huge distance. You don't have to throw it a huge distance. You just got to get it on the right line.
But do they have like a punt passing kick for flags?
No. but you can throw it 15, 20, 22 yards pretty easy. You know, you can throw it pretty good to get it to the spot.
Have you ever thrown a flag at a player out of frustration?
No. I'll tell you what I did do. Years ago, when I was in high school ball, we used to wear the flag in our back pocket. Most officials wear it down in the front. Yeah, yeah. And I went to throw the flag, and at that time, we didn't have all the official supplies like you have now. I used to go to the hardware store and get a fishing weight to put in the yellow
he
flag.
He went to the hardware store.
Yeah.
A fishing weight.
Imagine how old I am.
You can see how well the NFL really pays well, don't they?
So I had this weight in my flag, and it was in the back, and I was on the wing, and I went to throw it, and it got caught in the back of my pants, and I swung it. Swung it like this, and it went across, hit the kid in the helmet. The kid looked at me and said, "Now, don't go off sides again." You know, you got to try to cover yourself. But as you guys know, years ago.
Focusing on Rusty again, you know, celebration, come on, they have, like, cut that down. They're throwing a flag for guys celebrating. You know what would be great? What if somebody goes ahead and gets a touchdown? They got to, and then in order to not be penalized, they run it to the ref, and the ref does a celebration. That would be awesome. How about the ref? How about Rusty?
You stayed on theme, Lenny.
Rusty going ahead and winding it up. Throwing it down.
Boy, you just won't get off of us. Do you want the lights on or off at that time when we do?
It's a different set of lights.
But you know, you talk about celebration, boy, it leaves so much to the imagination on what you're going to penalize and whatnot. I think guys should be happy, great, and everything. But you know, they call it long, drawn out, choreographed, and et cetera,
et cetera. You're supposed to act like you've been there.
Lou Holtz made that statement years ago. Act like you've been there before.
That's right. Don't
you
be
know,
a punk.
Score. Put the ball down, give it to the referee, you know, and I don't even care if you slam it down, but you don't have to dance. You don't have to call your mom on the phone. You don't have to go you're upright. You know, come on, guys.
But the goofiest thing that we ever did was they filled the swimming pool full of Jell-O, and people could pay to watch Gary and I dive into this pool of Jell-O. And he and I raised $100,000 doing that.
That's hilarious.
That was the goofiest thing I've ever done.
I love that. And, you know, at least when you go underwater, you can actually eat Jell-O.
That's right. That's right.
Can you actually swim in Jell-O?
You actually could because it's so soft in texture that you actually could.
That's ridiculous.
That's funny. Jesus. Probably the craziest Bill Parcells moment was one day we were getting our butts kicked. I think it might have been Philadelphia. We came in at halftime, and the room was quiet. The room was stoke quiet. Guys were mad. You know, what's going on? And Parcells comes in the locker room, and he has a garbage can full of garbage. And he takes the garbage can, and he dumps it in the middle of the meeting at halftime. And the guys look at each other, and we go, what the hell was that about? The next thing you know, because that's what you guys are playing like. And I might as well leave you right there with it. But that was a quietly kept Parcellsism.
Please visit www.thesportscircus.com for a complete list of featured guests and previous episodes.
So, you want to be in show business. Do people tell you that you're really funny, you have a great personality, and you should have your own talk show? Many of us have been told that, but we don't know how to get started. It's easier than you think. Let the pros at Cali Vegas give you a free talent evaluation. Call 949-445-1119 and learn how quickly you can create, produce, and host your very own talk show. Imagine not having to sit in traffic every day, commuting back and forth to the same old boring job. Get started in television or radio today with your free talent evaluation from Cali Vegas. Call 949-445-1119 or visit them online at calivegas.com. Make your dream come true today and create your new career and learn how to become a television or radio star with the help of Cali Vegas. 949-445-1119. Call now.
If you're living with diabetes and using insulin, you know the pain of pricking your fingers over and over again. Ouch! Well, by wearing a small remote device called a continuous glucose monitor, or CGM, you can reduce the pain of pricking your fingers. If you administer insulin three or more times per day or use an insulin pump, call now and learn how a CGM can help you.
Painless. No more pricking my finger.
No finger pricks.
Convenience. They delivered it free and they took care of all the paperwork.
You can reduce pain right away. Plus, it's accurate, easy to use, and helps you spend more time in range. And if you have insurance, you can get a new CGM at little or no out-of-pocket cost. Call now and get free shipping of your new CGM. Plus, we'll bill your insurance for you. 800-659-7805. 800-659-7805. 800-659-7805. That's 800-659-7805.
Are you a small business owner or pursuing the dream of starting your own company? Do you know where to start or how to grow that existing business? The American Business Trust Company has the answers you need. The American Business Trust Company can help you start up with capital, business strategy, sales, and marketing, and establish your company with a physical location or an online presence on the internet. You decide. You bring the idea. Then American Business Trust can help with the rest. For a free evaluation, visit them online at abtrustco.com. That's abtrustco.com. Or call them at 657-600-1876. That's American Business Trust Company. 657-600-1876. Call them today. They'll help your business right away. That's American Business Trust Company. Online at abtrustco.com. American Business Trust Company.
That's the sound of sizzling, dry-aged USDA Prime Wagyu and Angus steaks from UppercutChops.com. They're best-in-class filet mignons, New York steaks, and the king of all steaks, the tomahawk and cowboy cut ribeyes, are the best in the business. Even their Prime Wagyu burgers will likely be the best you've ever had. Browse the full selection of steaks and chops at UppercutChops.com from the comfort of your home or on your mobile device. UppercutChops.com delivers all-natural, dry-aged USDA Prime Wagyu and Angus steaks and chops directly to your door without the hassle of going to the grocery store and fight crowds to pick from a small selection of average and best meats with injected steroids, fillers, and coloring added to look good. Find out what's for dinner at UppercutChops.com or call 702-799-9935. That's 702-799-9935. 702-799-9935. Or make your selection directly at UppercutChops.com.
This is Tommy John, and you're listening to the Sports Circus. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from the Amp.TV mobile studios here in fabulous Las Vegas. That's AAMP.TV. Folks, make sure you check out thesportscircus.com for our upcoming guest, our prior guest, our podcast, and also check out our partners page. We have some fantastic partners represented, such as the College of Southern Nevada Athletics. Check them out for upcoming events at csncoyotes.com. That's csncoyotes.com. And welcome back to everybody listening in on iHeartRadio, Spotify, and our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast, hotel television, AMP TV, AAMP.TV, and those streaming at thesportscircus.com. We're here again with Neil Donell, lead vocals for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame band Chicago. It's incredible to have him here. The guy could sing. He could do impressions. There's all kinds of cool stuff he could do. What can't you do, Neil? Come on.
Just about everything else I can't do. No, I'm just a regular guy here in Toronto who has a weird job. You know, that's pretty much how I describe it. You know.
And also a former hockey player, too, for all you sports enthusiasts. Yes, this is a sports show. Neil, how many times have you been to a stadium and you've maybe in between you've been listening to the music or whatnot, maybe there's a TV timeout or whatever it is, and you've heard something that you've either written, sang, or been a part of on the overhead speaker?
Too often to count, to be honest with you. You know, I've been doing this for such a long time and been involved with such a myriad of different projects over the years. It happens a lot. In fact, when they opened the Sky Dome here in Toronto, I was part of the music for that, you know, that the opening ceremonies of that. So, happens quite frequently.
Okay, Neil, so the people around you, well, let's just say you're sitting with one or two or three people, whatever, and they don't say anything. They're like, no, we don't want to say anything. But when you hear it, you kind of crack a smile like, yeah, man, I'm part of that, or I wrote that, or that's my music.
It's a strange feeling, you know, sometimes, you know, because sometimes it can just come right out of the blue. You know, you don't expect it. And you know, people send me things all the time that I've worked on that I totally forgot that I'd worked on. In fact, just this week, a couple of people, I guess people are reminiscing right now a little bit, but this week, a couple of people sent me songs that I had recorded for them. I can't even remember. I don't even remember when. And I don't remember. I didn't remember the songs, but it clearly was me. But when you do that much work, you know, over that period of time, it's you can't remember everything you've done.
Well, sure. It has to be a cool feeling. I don't know. I've never had that experience. And I don't know. It's just one of those, wow, I can't believe that's right. I did that. I mean, it must be kind of an interesting feeling. But at the same time, there's that fulfillment factor. A lot of people in life are missing the fulfillment factor. Would you agree?
Yeah. I'm very, very fortunate. You know, it was the old expression that, you know, if you love what you do, you'll never work a day in your life. So, I mean, the music business, the entertainment business, as you know, is a double-edged sword. You know, there are stresses involved with it. Touring is not the easiest thing in the world to do. You know, when the band does more than 100 shows a year, so we're out a lot. And, you know, a lot of times you pull into the next town at 7 or 8 o'clock in the morning, and you've been traveling in the tour bus all night, and the roads are rough, so you haven't had much sleep, and then, you know, you got to get yourself up to do the show that night, because there are 5 or 6 or 7 or 10,000 people that are showing up. And as soon as you hear the music, you know, you get that rush of adrenaline. To me, it's almost like somebody has stuck a hypodermic in my arm. I can pretty much pinpoint the minute, you know, to the second where I get that adrenaline rush, and you just get on stage and it's just magic.
Okay, so how many times have you been on stage and said, thank you, Chicago, or thank you, Detroit, and you're in, like, Cleveland or something? Have you ever done that one?
I have never done that. I have never done that. So far.
Right. But
I've seen people do it. Believe me. I've seen many people do it. It's
and then the crowd boos because you're not saying the right city, right?
Yeah. There's a pretty good story that very famous artist not so long ago. He was in Canada, And he was doing a show in Montreal. This is a very big name artist, and I think I'm not going to mention his name, but because everybody in the world knows who this is. And he was on stage at this brand new venue in Montreal, and the mayor of Montreal was there. And, you know, there's this huge rivalry between Montreal and Toronto. And he did his first song, and he said, "Oh, it's great to be back here in Toronto." You know, to Montreal. Oh, I mean, I would have loved to have been a fly on the wall for that one, because I guess, you know, you got a few looks.
Oh, man. Folks, we're here with Neil Donnell, lead vocals for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame band Chicago. Welcome back to everybody watching on Hotel Television, our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates. I think we also have a question from the chat. Sonar, who do we have?
Absolutely. We've got another question from the chat, and they come in. As a lead singer, what do you do on stage without an instrument?
What do I do on stage without an instrument? Well, you know, you can dance around, you can move around, you can wander around the stage, you can interact with the other guys in the band. I don't play guitar on every song in the show. I play guitar on a bunch of songs in the show, but I'm used to doing that. You know, most of my life I've just been out front. You know, in fact, there's an organization that I work with that does concerts with symphony orchestras all over North America. And they wouldn't let us play instruments on those shows. They just want the singers just out front with the mic and interacting with the audience and, you know, that kind of thing.
You know, it's funny you say that, because I think back to all the concerts I've been to, quite a few of them just as a concert goer. And I would look at, it depends on, of course, who the band is. I mean, if it's Robert Plant standing up there for Led Zeppelin, you know, just basically howling into a microphone, just tearing it up, that's one thing. But sometimes I look at the lead singer and I say, well, he looks a little confused or he looks a little bored. Everybody else is hammering their instruments or doing whatever they're doing. And there have been some concerts I've been to and seen the front guy, not really know their place on the stage. I can't really say that, but you know what I'm saying? That they look a little uncomfortable because everyone else is doing something and they're not.
Well, yeah, it depends on the show and the band. You know, as far as Chicago goes, you know, because it's such a large band, there's so many people in the group now, there's 10 of us on stage, we have to kind of know where we all are at any given moment. Right. So you don't run into somebody, you know.
But you could go down like dominoes.
Well, you know, you could, you know, the horn guys are moving around a lot. You know, they move around a lot. And you don't want to run into Jimmy Panko's trombone slide. And it's actually, he has damaged it like that. And so when the guys have got instruments on their mouths, you know, when they got those hard mouthpieces, you don't want to be hitting them, knocking them, because you could knock a tooth out. Same thing with the guys in front of a microphone. If you hit the microphone stand, that microphone hits them in the mouth. I mean, you've got to be very aware of where you are at any given moment, you know, when there's that many people.
So, Neil, how often does that happen?
Thankfully, it doesn't happen very often, because everything is worked out beforehand. You know, in a lot of the stages are quite large, so it's not usually an issue. But, you know, you're supposed to know where you are at any given time, in any given song. You know, you have a designated sort of area that you're supposed to be in. I mean, you have some freedom to move around to some degree, but the other guys are moving too at different points of the show. So you got to be wary of that and not having any collisions, you know, because people could actually get hurt, you know?
Right. You know, when you think of being a concert goer, Sonar, you don't really think of seeing collisions on stage, but I guess, hey, the good news is, Neil's a former hockey player, so he could certainly dish it out, and he could take a shot, too.
That's true. I was a defenseman back in the day, and not a bad one either. So, you know, I played up front a lot as a defenseman. I didn't get a lot of goals, but I assisted a lot, and because I'm a big guy. I'm 6'2", and back when I was playing hockey, I was around 190, 195. So... Mm-hmm.
You know what it's like to take a hit? And you know what it's like to dish it out at the same time. What about hockey fights? Okay, so let's go back to the hockey world real quick. Were you the guy that would drop the gloves and really get into it?
I hate to say that I did on occasion. I did on occasion, you know. And it was weird because it was always the little guys that, you know, that wanted to take the big guy down. I found that a lot, you know. And because I have long arms, I would kind of just hold out my glove and just, you know, I could keep the guy away from me with your hand, you know, just by doing that, because I'd be swinging it. And you could sort of keep
that's great stuff. At a fist.
Yeah, absolutely true.
So you're in the home of basically NHL headquarters in Toronto. In fact, one of the friends of our show here is one of the replay officials for goaltender interference in the booth. Pretty interesting stuff. So I hear what's going on over there. Yeah, Paul Dvorsky was with us last week. You know, Paul's been a ref for, I don't know, 32 years or something to the effect.
Yeah, that's very cool. Yeah.
Yeah, well, Devo's been around for a long time.
It's Canada, you know, it's the national sport here. Actually, it's supposed to be lacrosse, but you know, I guess technically, but I mean, hockey is, I mean, that people are just beside themselves right now. You know, they're running old replays of old games right now and stuff, but everybody's chomping at the bit for, you know, sports to get back going. So, you know, we're looking forward to that here.
Yeah. All right. So, Neil, we have just a couple of minutes left in the show here, and I want to make sure that you have a chance to get out all your projects, your interests, the things that are important to you, your social media. Go ahead and take a minute and talk about that.
Yeah, well, you know, the band is back recording a little bit now, so you can find some of that stuff on YouTube. And I do have a record that I'm still selling from my website, which is neildonell.com. Anyone who wants to go and check that out, you can listen to samples of that record. It's called Sodace. It's a bunch of cover songs. There's a one original song of my own that was written for my sons. And there is a Chicago song that I recorded. I'm very proud of the record. I'm sure you'll recognize virtually all the songs on the record. And I'm working on a new project now. I'm just finishing it up to have another record out later this year. And, you know, just like everybody else, I'm trying to stay healthy and collaborating with different people, you know, on different music projects. So that's keeping me pretty occupied right now.
That's great. Well, hopefully on your next time around here in Las Vegas, you'll stop in and see us and have a laugh with us. Maybe bring your guitar and bring your pads and gloves, because we may drop the gloves. I'm kidding.
Yeah. I'll try to fit it all in my guitar case.
Yes, everything will fit in there for sure.
I've still got a bag full of old hockey gear in the basement there. Yeah.
All right. Well, Neil, thank you so much. Folks, a big round of applause for Neil Donell, lead vocalist for Rock and Roll Hall of Fame band Chicago, for joining us today. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, and we'll see you next time right here back on the circus. Until then, so long, everyone.
That's the sound of sizzling, dry-aged USDA Prime Wagyu and Angus steaks from UppercutChops.com. They're best-in-class filet mignons, New York steaks, and the king of all steaks, the tomahawk and cowboy cut ribeyes, are the best in the business. Even their Prime Wagyu burgers will likely be the best you've ever had. Browse the full selection of steaks and chops at UppercutChops.com from the comfort of your home or on your mobile device. UppercutChops.com delivers all-natural, dry-aged USDA Prime Wagyu and Angus steaks and chops directly to your door. Without the hassle of going to the grocery store and fight crowds to pick from a small selection of average and best meats with injected steroids, fillers, and coloring added to look good. Find out what's for dinner at UppercutChops.com or call 702-799-9935. That's 702-799-9935. 702-799-9935. Or make your selection directly at UppercutChops.com.